of the YouTube. It's Cuddle of Death here. Very happy day. Woo! And you guys can probably hear a little bit of air in my mic, and that's because I have the fan on because it's freaking hot in here. And I don't want to get too hot, and I was really, really hot earlier, so I'm like, I gotta record with a fan on. But anyways, we are back with episode 2 of our Youngster Joey challenge, or Rattata solo run, whatever you'd like to call it. In the previous episode, we did capture our Rattata. We also got an HM slave. We started... we're gonna have another HM slave, excuse me. This Bellsprout's gonna get traded for an Onyx because we are in Violet City, and I also do have my Chikorita in the PC so that I could use it for cut later, but since we don't have cut, I am not too concerned about that right now. We'll get it in a little bit. And I think this is the guy that wants the Bellsprout. Or it's the other dude to the right. I think it's this little kid right here. Let's see. I collect Pokemon. Do you have Bellsprout? Want to trade it for my Onyx? Yes. So we are going to go ahead and trade this really quick. Nice and cool, old school trading. Number 69, Bellsprout, good choice, good choice. Going to get an Onyx in return. This will save us a little bit of time because Onyx can have like Rock Smash. And I think Rock Smash isn't even an HM in this game. It was later though. But you can have Rock Smash. You can also have Strength. I don't know what else Onyx can learn, but... we at least have those covered. And then we have cut covered, and then later we'll have surf covered, and then later we'll have fly covered. So, also, I did do some checking to see if my Rattata was going to be okay with fighting ghost-type Pokemon. It does learn Pursuit on level up. It does not learn Bite in this generation on level up. However, it can get stuff like Super Fang, Dig, which in this generation will affect ghost Pokemon. It can also get Blizzard. Plenty of other TMs that will affect ghost-type Pokemon. And give me just a second, guys. My headset's actually about to die on me, so I must plug it in. One sec. Okay, I am back, and now my headset's not gonna die on me. So we did get our brand new HM slave named Rocky. What item does he have on him? He has a Bitterberry. We're gonna steal his Bitterberry. He does not need it. And we are gonna head straight for the Sprout Tower. I don't think there's anything else that's special in here right now, because I mean, we have to go through the Sprout Tower to get to the gym. I can't remember if you have to do that, but I think so. I don't know. Regardless, you have to, yeah, you have to, even if you don't have to go through it for the gym, you do have to go through it to get an HM. However hard we battle, the tower will stand strong. Man, I have so many memories playing Gold, Silver, and Crystal, like back whenever I was in school and everything. Sage Nico. Nico, Nico. Now we get to take out a lot of these Bellsprouts. Ooh, and a cool move that Templeton learns, I believe, at level 13 is Hyper Fang. And then Super Fang is like way later, like in the level 30s or something like that. I feel like my nose just got... oh my god, that was a critical hit. I feel like my nose is a little stuffy right now. Sorry, sorry about that, you guys. But it happens. It happens sometimes. And now seems to be one of those times. in episode 1, I actually just posted it as soon as I could after I recorded and edited and rendered and whatnot. And, you know, it actually went up a few minutes ago before I started recording this episode. And already people are very interested in this solo run. So I'm very happy for that. I'm happy that you guys are interested. And I hope that you guys continue to enjoy it. And as always, if you are enjoying it, make sure to smash the hell out of that like button. And if you've started your own Youngster Joey challenge, make sure to let me know the progress in any of the Youngster Joey challenge videos down in the comment section below. Because I want to know your progress. And I just like to know, like, if you give up or if you just can't handle the solo run. I mean, this is a perfect opportunity to do your first solo run if you've never done one. Ooh, and I have bad hiccups too. Whew! Okay, I'm good now. I was like, about to hiccup everywhere again. Okay. I'm so sad that we don't have running shoes in this game though. That's the only thing I wish that we had. We do have a paralyzed heal though, so just in case little Templeton gets paralyzed, we will be okay. We gotta do a lot of battles though, which is great because it's gonna give us a decent amount of experience, and we should be okay to go straight to the gym after Sprout Tower, if I am not mistaken. It should be quite easy to do. We have Sage Chow. Speaking of Chow, I'm actually wanting to chow down right now. I'm actually hungry. Hungry as hell. Ugh. I feel like now that I saw his name, and I don't know if this is racist or not. If it is, don't take it as a racist comment, because it just made me think of the Chinese food, like chow mein and whatnot. And I want some Chinese food. Even though I don't eat chow mein, I want Chinese food. This, like, stuffy nose crap is, like, really starting to bug me. Okay, so now we have another bell sprout. Trying to figure out what's going on outside. Some people are making some noise. And I wish this would start one-shotting these. I mean, if we would get a crit, it would have one-shot this bell sprout. This evil little... Look at that! There's a critical hit. This evil little bell sprout. But at least, I mean, all these Pokemon are going to be bell sprouts in here. I think some of them have rap later on. Like the main sage guy in here. I think he's got rap on it. Maybe not. I can't remember. But he does have a Hoot Hoot. The only Pokemon you will fight in here through trainers, not wild Pokemon, are Bellsprout and Hoot Hoot. There's another critical hit too. Outside of that, you can run into, I believe, it's either Bellsprout or Rattata. I think it's one of those two. And Ghastly for sure. I kind of need to heal a little bit. So let's go and use our potion. We did buy a lot of them, and it's just enough to heal us back to 100%. That's awesome. I like that. I was going to say, there's an item up here. Is it escape rope? Exaccuracy. Now, the escape rope is literally right next to the sage guy, the main guy, the main dude. He's got the escape rope next to him. Don't ask me why. Yeah, okay, so it's Rattata and Ghastly up here in here. Little Templeton's brothers and sisters are in here. What a creepy place to be. But I guess it makes sense because Rattata are everywhere and they're constantly breeding and constantly making other Rattata. This is like an optional battle, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Sway like the leaves in the wind. I need like a Claritin after this. I swear, Claritin should totally sponsor me because of how much I use the ready tabs. I love those freaking things. And I know in other videos I've mentioned them before, but they are amazing. I just like take a little ready tab and I am ready to go. Nose is clear, everything's good. They are so helpful. Templeton is almost level 10. Probably will get level 10 off of this battle. Not this, like, kill, but... Look at these critical hits back to back! Like, last battle, the battle before that? Yeah, we're definitely gonna hit level 10 before this battle's over, which is nice. Okay. Critical hit, please? Nope. Ah! That's my response, is, we need, like, more critical hits. I'm so sad about that, but it's okay. Because good things will come to Templeton, as he is going to be. He's working his way up to be in the top percentage. And the final Bellsprout. Okay. We should maybe be level 11 by the time we get out here. That wasn't a critical hit, but it's okay because we hit level 10. And now it seems like we can one-shot at least the level 3 ones, which makes sense because, you know, we are kind of higher level than they are. I remember playing Pokemon Gold for the first time whenever it came out in Japan. My mom was signed up with a survey site. Back in the day, they had really cool survey sites. You would take surveys and start accumulating points. And then you could spend them on anything, and one of the things you could get was Pokemon Gold from Japan. And since it wasn't out in the US yet, my mom went ahead and got it, and she got it in the mail, and I started playing it. It was my first, like, second-gen game, and I was so happy. It was my first Japanese game, I should say, as well. And I freaking loved it. Now, I don't know if there's any sites out there that exist like that anymore. I'm aware that there are plenty of survey sites where you accumulate points, but I don't think any of them are as cool as what this would have been. It was probably like 1999, I believe, is whenever this game came out in Japan. So yeah, 1999, I was only 9 years old, and they had a cool survey site where you could take a lot of surveys, get points, and get Pokemon games, I guess, or anything else. So, pretty cool. I will never ever forget that. And even though I couldn't understand any of it, I learned very quickly from playing the previous Pokemon games, and I completed it before the English versions came out. And later I started to learn some of the Pokemon names and the attacks just from playing the game and leveling up and being like, oh, this is Tackle, or This means Pokeball, because I just tested it out and got used to it. So, a lot of people have asked me before, whenever they started releasing the games in Japan, before they started giving, like, a global release, how can you understand some of the Japanese? Well, that's your answer. It's just because I played some of the Japanese games in the past, but I don't actually read Japanese. Uh-oh. Had a little issue right there. I'm not sure what was going on. That was weird. Oh, well. It was like a little stutter, but hopefully it doesn't do that again. Otherwise, I gotta see what's causing it. Maybe there's a lot of stuff going on, because I do have a lot of things open, and I'm, like, notorious for that. Oh! That was, like, extra damage right there. Oh, yeah, we're definitely gonna... Maybe we'll hit level 12. That's what I'm hoping for, at least. Fight everyone! Everybody. Because we're almost at the end of Sprout Tower anyway, so... This will be really good. Sage Troy. I think he's got a Hoot Hoot. Maybe he doesn't, but I think he does, if I remember correctly. Look at little Templeton. Gonna level up again. Do lots of damage. Ooh, that was a crit. Yeah. Okay, we're just gonna quick attack to take it out. The only thing annoying about Hoot Hoot, I believe, is that the sages, like the main dude, has hypnosis on it. Yeah, this dude has Hoot Hoot. It's so cute though. Back in the day, I did not like it at all. I thought it was really ugly. The foresight though. So Templeton has been identified as a little rat buddy. Okay. Now we're gonna take on this dude up here. And it's my rival. You are indeed skilled as a trainer. As promised, here is your HM, but let me say this. You should treat your Pokemon better. The way you battle is far too harsh. Pokemon are not tools of war. Huff. He claims to be the elder, but he's weak. It stands to reason I'd never lose to fools who babble about being nice to Pokemon. I only care about strong Pokemon that can win. I really couldn't care less about weak Pokemon. So he used an escape rope. And he's out of there! And we can't... Actually, this is the escape rope right here. So it's like, why do you specifically have a rope to escape? Like, why can't I just pick up, like, a rope? Why does it have to be called an escape rope? I understand it's used to escape, but yeah. I don't know. I just want another rope. Maybe I want to, like, wrangle myself a Tauros or something. So good of you to come here. Sprout Tower is a place of training. People and Pokemon test their bonds to build a bright future together. I am the final test. Allow me to check the ties between your Pokemon and you. Now, I must say I do like this. I like the way that they implemented this dude. In Generation 2, because it's before the gym, and it's like just a little extra, like, test. And it makes you feel good about yourself, at least for the first time playing through. It's like a really nice idea, because especially, like, back in the day whenever I couldn't read, I thought this was, like, gonna be some big, gigantic event, even though it wasn't. This guy's gonna go straight for the growth. It's not gonna help him out any, because we should be able to take him out. Templeton did not miss. Templeton should be able to take this down, and it is down and out. Why am I, like, shoutcasting this right now? We're gonna take on the next Pokemon, which is going to be the second Bellsprout of this dude, Sage Lee. Sage Lee sends out his other Bellsprout. Is at level 7. It is level 7. We gotta take this out, too. I do believe his Hoot Hoot might cause a little bit of a problem if he does have Hypnosis. And if he manages to hit it, he does carry that Foresight, though, so he could just as easily use that Foresight and then go for Hypnosis. Down goes the second Bellsprout. Now all we have to deal with is the Hoot Hoot. Templeton levels up to level 12. One level, I believe, off of learning Hyper Fang, which is going to deal massive damage and help us out a crap load in this let's play. Here's the Hoot Hoot, level 10 represent. It's okay if he does put us to sleep because we can't, oh gosh, that was a critical hit, but we can easily heal up. We do have a ton of potions though. There's the Foresight. He might go for the Hypnosis now, otherwise maybe we can take him out. He is one away. He goes for the tackle, pretty much dooming himself because I don't believe Sage Lee will use a potion. He does not, and Templeton takes the victory. Templeton wins! So now we can get the HM, I believe. Is it flash or cut? Yeah, it's flash. Alright. So now we can see in the darkest of places, even where J YouTube Gamer stays. Alright, so now we can use our low escape rope here, go take on Falkner's gym, and hopefully we can prevail. Because right now, we need to earn our first badge. And I know that we can do it. I know that Templeton can prevail. Templeton is the best. Templeton is better than the rest. I think Chikorita could probably learn Flash too. I didn't even think about that. But probably can. Ugh. Alright, so time to take on our first gym, which is not that far away. And we are going to take Falkner down. Alright, so the very first trainer, Ceres, let me see if you are good enough to face Falkner. Well, stand aside, fair trainer, for we will take you down. Templeton does possess the power to take you down, Bird Keeper Abe. I almost call him Abe. Bird Keeper Abe, as well as Falkner. I can't even speak right now. Woo! Alright, so level 9 Spiro is nothing to Templeton. Templeton could reach level 13 before Falkner, though that would be amazing, because then we'll have the Hyper Fang. Watch it be some other level, and I read it wrong, and it's like a lower level for a different game. That Peck is doing a fair amount of damage, though, so a crit would really hurt. But we should be alright with potions, I think. Actually, I don't know. I think we might have picked up an X item earlier, but I do believe it's probably only X accuracy. This can't be true! Let's see. This guy probably has a Pidgey. I can't remember what Pokemon they have. The keyword is guts. Those here are training night and day to become bird Pokemon masters. Come on! So we must best the birds. We gotta best all the birds. Bird Keeper Rod. Pidgey. Oh, these things can be annoying because of sand attack. That would not be fun whatsoever. So Templeton is out on the field ready to take down these Pidgey right here. Right here, right here. Maybe he's got a Pidgey and a Spearow. I don't know. We're going to find out, though. It doesn't matter because Templeton will take them down regardless of what they are. We don't discriminate on what type of bird you are. Ooh. Oh, I think it's going to be really close. It is another Pidgey. Oops. Can't change our Pokemon here. So, should be able to easily take this one down as well. And hopefully the gym will go smoothly with a flawless victory against Falkner. That was a nice critical hit right there, but I have a better attack for you. I am gonna go back out and heal, though. I'm not gonna use my potions. Oh my goodness, we're so close. I might actually just walk in the grass and take out a Pokemon or something. That just seems like the smartest decision to make right now. And plus, we have some extra time to kill for that, so it works out just fine for us, I believe. So, let's go ahead and heal up. We're gonna super speed that and then go over here. I'm not gonna have like a short little grinding montage because literally we only should have to kill a very little amount of Pokemon to level up here. Alright. Yes, yes, Hyper Fang! Woo! Alright, that should help us quite a bit. And then we're just gonna go. We'll heal just to be safe so that we have full HP. And now we can take on Gym Leader Falkner, who will fall to us. Alright, back in the gym. And look at this, dollar sign, 301 plus views. A nice and powerful dollar sign. I'm Falkner, the violent Pokemon Gym Leader. People say... I was thinking of something there. People say you can clip flying-type Pokemon's wings with a jolt of electricity. I won't allow such insults to bird Pokemon. I'll show you the real power of the magnificent bird Pokemon. Alright, Falkner, let's see what you got, but you shouldn't really be able to take us down. We should be okay, especially with Hyper Fang, which isn't 100% accurate, and it does actually have a chance to flinch, which would be rather nice, and it should also do a decent amount of damage. Can I move this right now? Okay, Hyper Fang time. It looks like Stomp. Ooh, it takes it out in one go, look at that. Ooh, Templeton. Templeton is the best. Here comes the Pidgeotto. Will Templeton be able to take this Pidgeotto down in one hit? I highly doubt it, and I would be quite shocked if he does. Because Pidgeotto has a decent amount more HP than Pidgey does. Woo, that was close. He goes for the gust. It's not going to do anything to us at all. And, oh, look at that. Templeton decides to miss. I knew this was going to happen. There we go. And that Pidgeotto should be down and out. It is. That nets us the very first badge for our Youngster Joey challenge for Pokemon Crystal. Darn, my dad's cherished bird Pokemon. He wasn't even using his own. All right, take this. It's the official Pokemon League Zephyr badge. And we made lots of money out of that flawless victory. So yay for Templeton. He is the best. He now has one badge under his belt. Zephyr badge raises the attack power of Pokemon. It also enables Pokemon to use Flash if they have it any time. Here, take this too. Whew. By using a TM, a Pokemon will instantly learn a new move. Think before you act. A TM can be used only once. TM 31 contains Mudslap, which we can actually learn, by the way. It reduces the enemy's accuracy while it causes damage. In other words, it is both defensive and offensive. Not as much offense as it is defensive, but we got our first batch. We're going to exit the premises here, and all of a sudden we get a phone call from Professor Elm. Hello, Joey? Why did I get so excited? Hello, Joey. Hello, Joey. We discovered something about the egg. My assistant is at the Pokemon Center in Violet City. Could you talk to him? Click. So basically what's going to happen here is we're going to get a free egg to walk around. We're going to get it bestowed upon us. We can walk around, have a good fun time, good fun jolly time with that. So let's go ahead and take this egg from this dude, and I believe we can actually head over to Ruins of Alf to do the little puzzle deal, which is optional, but I always like to do the puzzle. It makes me feel cool. I don't know about you guys. Maybe you guys hate it. I'm not a big fan of Unknown. I'm gonna heal up again though. And we're gonna go ahead and take Chikorita out, slave, I should say, and hopefully learn Flash in a second. But first, to the Ruins of Alf. Or to the puzzle area for the Ruins of Alf so that we could start finding Unknown in there if we ever decide to come back for any reason whatsoever. Here is a paralyzed cure berry, I guess. That's what that is. I think Ruins of Alf is optional though, if I'm not mistaken. But hey, whatever, we can go ahead and go to it anyways. Just extra content for you guys. Because now that it's optional, people don't really care about it as much. So let's go ahead and solve this puzzle. So I always like to do the corners first, and you know, everything after that pretty much comes naturally for the most part. Now as a kid I got confused a lot, but I also was really bad with puzzles. Like this, let's see, is that right? Yeah, it is. That's not meant to go here, and I think that one's there, this one's here. And then this one is here. Right there, almost done. I think it's like this. No, I think it needs to go the other way around. Yeah, otherwise he's gonna look a little cross-eyed there. Otherwise we gotta switch the eyes back. I did that again. All right, we should be good with this. Yes, there we go. There's the Kabuto. We have solved the Ruins of Alf puzzle. How creepy would this be in real life? This would be creepy as hell. And then you have the creepy music. There's a strange presence here. I always wanted the little exclamation point unknown or the question mark unknown. Did you guys ever get those? Because I never went through all of the trouble to get them. Look! It's Jay and his domain! There's Jay YouTube Gamer right here. We're actually going to get out of here now though. I forgot if this says anything. It does not. Oh, it's a replica of an ancient Pokemon. I don't know which one it is. Probably the unknown, but... Look at all of these unknown right here. Alright, time to leave. Actually, because we did do the unknown puzzle, and everything. I might go ahead and stop this episode right here. Yeah, I will. So if you guys enjoyed watching us obtain our first batch, make sure to smash the hell out of that like button. Stay tuned for more of the Youngster Joey Pokemon Crystal Challenge. I hope you guys are enjoying yours if you are participating in one as well. Best of luck if you're just now starting one. Let me know how your progress is currently going down in the comment section below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!